I'm sure that our speaker will bring valuable insights into today's topic, which is human capital formation during the early years. The topic is complex, given the large number and sensitive nature of some of the intervening factors, and crucial to any debate on development, inequality, and equal opportunity.
He has written especially, but not limited to, topics related to the theory and empirics of household consumption, savings, labor supply behavior, risk sharing both within the household and across different households. And more recently, he has been involved very heavily in the study of early life interventions and their importance for human capital accumulation. That's going to be the topic of today's presentation.
Human capital is perceived to be important in growth and development. It's probably, some people see it as an effective way of reducing inequality and increasing equity of opportunity. Human capital is a very complex process. Human capital is probably a multidimensional object. If you think of a production function, there are probably several factors of production that enter that we are used to call with an age. Probably that age should be a vector where different skills are play different roles in the production function and therefore pay different prices and get different remunerations in the labor market. We also know that early years are important because they are there is overwhelming evidence that they have very long-run consequences. If you run early regressions and put birth weight on the right-hand side, you will find very significant effects. What do we know and what we don't know in this field? We know that early years are important. We know that nutrition is important. We know that stimulation is key to child development, that probably is even more effective than nutrition itself. And we know that there are these dynamic interactions that may play an important role. However, there is a huge amount that we don't know. And the way I characterize is that three categories of things that we don't know. So the first is literally the production function, and excuse me, the use of economic jargon. We don't fully understand the shape or the parameters of the production function. The second thing is that we don't fully understand what parents do. What are the constraints that they face? Is it resources? Is it information? Is it attitudes, beliefs? The final third big area is that, okay, we know that the Jamaica intervention worked, but how did it work? And especially, how can this thing be scaled up? What does it take to scale things up? And I think that's what doctors call the distinction between effectiveness and efficacy of interventions. That's a big unknown. So let me talk a little bit about a theoretical framework. So we have a production function where the human capital at time t plus 1, or age t plus 1, depends on human capital t, depends on background variables and investment and some shocks. The point is that if I'm only interested in the impacts, then I can just compare the means. So I compare the treated kids to the non-treated kids. And that's the impact of the intervention. Think for policy design, what you want to know, however, is how this intervention, if you do have an impact, is how this intervention is having an impact. And putting everything within the framework of the production function and the investment function allows you to say something. So let me conclude. The study of human capital accumulation, I think, is important, but I think there is still much we do not know. So this is a research agenda for the future: better measurement tools, use of structural models to identify the production function and parental behavior. That's key to construct the policy interventions. And then all this should lead to better and more effective policies. Thank you very much.